Media Watch presents...
Don't be a TV!
Television, the drug of a nation. Breeding ignorance and feeding radiation on television. The drug of a nation. Breeding ignorance and feeding radiation. TV, its satellite links are United States of unconsciousness. Apathetic, therapeutic, and extremely addictive. The methadone metronome, pumping out 150 channels 24 hours a day. You can flip through all of them, and still there's nothing worth watching.
Is tomorrow's memory 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hi, welcome to NTV, not TV.
Yay! Just like in the movies. I'm a real hero.
What is real?
Why do bimbos get all the men? Next, Sally.
Where are your values from?
Friendship has a sound on its own.
Is TV your best friend?
Kathy is 8, and she's addicted. It changes the way she talks, the way she acts, the way she thinks. She is addicted to television.
Are you addicted to television? Hi, my name is Laura Chavez. Did you know that kids spend twice as much time in front of the TV as they do in school? I'm here to help you think more critically about all forms of the media. Time Warner owns Warner Brothers, HBO, Cinemax, Time, Sports Illustrated, and Life magazines. Rupert Murdoch owns the Fox Network, newspapers, magazines, and TV stations. Ted Turner owns TNT, CNN, TBS, Headline News, and the Cartoon Network. What's the impact of these media empires?
Will we have less choice?
Will prices go up?
Will local jobs disappear?
Who benefits when one company controls the TV, the radio, the cable system, as well as the local newspaper?
Is this democratic?
This itch, what can stop it fast?
Our entire culture is saturated with advertising. Ever notice how the sound goes up during commercials?
Turn it up.
Way up.
Way up.
Turn it down.
Turn it down.
Way down.
Way down.
Turn it off.
Or how toys don't do the incredible things they do on TV.
So destruction in the Batman Returns handheld beam from Tiger.
The time has come to punish all.
Your favorite pop stars sell soda pop.
Diet Coke.
Your favorite athletes sell everything from chips to underwear. Human emotions are for sale. When real people are in emotional pain, advertisements promise to make you feel good.
Bring the Baron home tonight. Red Baron frozen pizza.
Camera angles, scary music, and special effects intensify the images to make products more alluring.
Al Cooper's bottle stops a thundering thirst when he...
bursts the bass!
Advertisers confuse us by placing their ads in a news format.
Another unexplained crop formation has been sighted. Looks like there's intelligent life out there, after all.
Or by turning it into a program.
That's incredible.
Thank you. Thank you, Beverly, so very much. And thank you, Jane. Stay with us, everyone. We'll be right back.
I've been nuked!
Some advertisers work directly with producers and editors to create programming and articles that make their products look good.
If I even look at a sink full of dishes, my hands go crazy. But now there's new Palmolive Sensitive Skin for dishes. It's free of dye.
Product placement is common. Advertisers control what people are allowed to see. A major magazine was forced to take Russian women off its cover because their advertiser, Revlon, thought the women weren't wearing enough makeup. This kind of corporate censorship goes on every day. Freedom of choice means the freedom to buy products.
Is this a choice?
Channel One, owned by Whittle and Time Warner, offers schools $50,000 worth of video equipment in exchange for the promise that every student must watch 4 commercials and a short newscast every day for at least 3 years. Channel One is using the news as an excuse to make $600,000 daily in ad revenue for their 4 commercial spots.
What if commercials sold ideas to make the world a better place instead of selling products?
Also at 11, one of the most beautiful women in the world is ready to give you some of her beauty secrets. We're going to have these stories, plus more troubles for Agnews.
The news, like most media, relies on ratings and sales. If advertisers don't like the news, they won't keep buying the time.
From ABC News, around the world and into your home, the stories that touch your life.
News information is not complete and holds a bias against certain people. According to a recent study, 9 out of 10 of the experts on ABC's Nightline were white men.
The absence of people of color in these important positions is part of the media's bias.
A camera caught this gunman taking 20 innocent people hostage.
The news sensationalizes murder. In one study, almost half of the violent crime stories printed in daily newspapers were about murders, even though murder is the least frequently occurring violent crime in America.
Sherman borrowed the storyline of a Hollywood thriller to come up with a murder plot that could make your blood run cold, and he nearly got away with it.
The news often explains in gruesome detail the sexual abuse and rape of women, yet they never tell us of the thousands of women who bravely fight off attackers. Why do news stories constantly remind women they might be attacked? The news has turned into another entertainment program. News of the recent Gulf War used theme music and logos. General Electric, who owns NBC, is one of the largest weapons producers. Westinghouse, who owns one of the largest broadcast groups, is another major defense contractor. These corporations want the public to applaud their high-tech weaponry. We now know that 70% of the so-called smart bombs that made surgical strikes actually missed their targets. Governments often work together with big media corporations to present information they want us to hear and to entertain us with what they think is appropriate. Why haven't we seen images of the 300,000 Iraqi people dead? Many of the dead were children.
War is not a video game!
Video games, which are deliberately targeted to boys, reward control, competition, and destruction. Boys learn to be the violent aggressors, while girls learn to be victims. Girls are denied their power and human dignity, while boys are denied compassion and expression of their feelings.
Never expected to face 3 ninja brothers.
She kicked their butts!
Boys learn that anything feminine is gross. Boys can't play dolls. They'd be called sissies. How will boys learn to be good fathers unless they learn to be more nurturing? Caring for children and playing with dolls can help. TV's teens are preoccupied with shopping, grooming, and dating. Girls on television read magazines, talk cosmetics, and feel ugly and depressed if, for example, her boyfriend dances with another girl.
Donna and Nancy Martin are wearing beachwear from Susie's Surf Shop.
The female character's academic or career plans are never a major part of the plot. In an attempt to copy the unrealistically thin actresses, dieting has become a major health problem for girls.
which incidentally, I'd be perfect to model, don't you think?
It's like a dream come true. Cinderella!
According to one survey, 81% of the 10-year-olds were on a diet. Beautiful people come in all shapes and sizes. Meanwhile, boys learn that violence is the best way to resolve their conflicts. Most cartoon heroes are blonde males, while evil characters are often dark-skinned and have foreign accents.
Give me what you stole.
But perhaps now you are wise enough to advise them against it. Right, Senor Bankman?
Absolutely, amigo.
Can evil characters be good? Do the evil people you see on cartoons or in the news have mothers or children? How would they treat people they loved? Can we ever learn to resolve our anger without violence?
I only told you to scare them.
People scare better when they're dying.
Once you kill four.
According to the Nielsen Index, kids watch 18,000 deaths and murders by age 18. Researchers say that TV violence is linked to 50% of the crime in the U.S. Violent acts appear 20 to 25 times an hour in children's daytime programming, compared to only 6 times an hour in evening adult programming.
Did I kill you? Santi puta, I'm gonna die!
MTV averages over 29 instances of violent or hostile images every single hour, and 41% of the kids in one study chose music videos as their favorite program. Music videos present a great deal of violent and sexual imagery that is male-oriented. Most of the women and girls on music videos are portrayed as sex objects and victims. Images like these numb and desensitize us, leading to an increased acceptance of rape. Guns N' Roses sings, "Welcome to the Jungle, I Wanna Watch You Bleed," and "I Used to Love Her, But I Had to Kill Her." Motley Crue's videos have women as sexual slaves in cages, and Rick James even rapes his girlfriend in his video. According to MTV, being abused is a mark of being desirable, and girls try to copy this ideal. For boys, music videos define a beautiful girl as someone who isn't really human, and will never say no. Why aren't loving and stable relationships portrayed as exciting?
Role models like these can threaten girls who are coming to terms with their own sexuality. A study of 3,000 children found at the age of 9, girls were confident, assertive, and felt positive about themselves. But by the time they reached high school, less than a third felt that way.
The barrage of degrading and woman-hating messages takes its toll. Unless girls are strongly supported to realize that the problem isn't with them, it's with the way they are shown and treated by society.
No wonder the U.S. doesn't have a female president or more serious stories written by or about women in the front section of newspapers.
Imagine independent female characters who take charge of situations.
Are respected professional leaders and whose appearance is unconventional or unimportant.
Imagine female actresses that view other women as allies, not as competitors.
Imagine affectionate male characters accepting help, being sensitive to feelings,
expressing their emotions, and caring for children.
Imagine male actors cleaning the toilet and having non-sexual friendships with women.
There are things you can do.
Think for yourself.
Talk back to your television.
You're smarter than you think you are. Trust your feelings. Form your own options. There are no right or wrong answers.
Don't waste your time with magazines or programs that glorify the rich and dehumanize the poor, or ones that glamorize violence, sexual abuse, or racism.
Write a letter.
Boycott products for sale during programs you don't like.
Create your own media.
pressure the media
to create more positive images
and role models.
Challenge it, support it, but never be silenced by it.
We have a lot to learn from those who are silenced and made invisible by the media.
What do people with disabilities have to teach us about perseverance and prejudice?
What do people from varied ethnic and racial groups have to teach us about Orgullo Cultural?
We can make it a priority to end racism, sexual violence, and even war.
We can learn new ways
to resolve conflicts.
Some say that for as long as
20,000 years of our human history on Earth,
men and women have lived in cooperative partnerships.
If media images reflect the society they exist in, we must ask ourselves whether we want to support the problem or be part of the solution.
TV is the reason why less than 10% of our nation reads books daily. Why most people think Central America means Kansas. Socialism means un-American, and apartheid is a new headache remedy. Absorbed in this world, it's so hard to find us. It shapes our minds the most. Maybe the mother of our nation should remind us that we're sitting too close to the television, the drug of the nation. Reading ignorance and feeding radiation on television. The drug of the nation. Reading ignorance and feeding radiation.
On the screen is an address where you can mail your tithe offering or gift of love.
Okay, got the idea? All right, now let's pass it.
Is it the reflector or the director? Does it imitate us or do we imitate it? Because a child watches 1,500 murders before he's 12 years old. And then we wonder why we created a Jason generation that learns to laugh rather than abhor the whore. TV is a place where armchair generals and quarterbacks can experience firsthand the excitement of video warfare as the theme song is sung in the background. Sugar sweet sitcoms that leave us with a bad actor taste, while pop stars metamorphosize into soda pop stars. You saw the video, you heard the soundtrack. Well, now go buy the soft drink. Well, the only cola that I support would be a Union COLA cost of living allowance on television.